everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing another sustainable haul. Surprise, surprise. I feel like I've been doing a lot of these mostly just because it is fast becoming a passion of mine. I've really been trying to focus on sustainable and ethical fashion. I am trying to work in some ideas that are more of a lower price point. I do recognize that sustainability comes with a higher price point just because of the production is a lot different. You are working with smaller quantities and so the runs tend to be a little bit more expensive, and I totally understand that. I'm trying to research a few brands that I do feel like are more fast fashion but are doing their best to have better sustainability practices, if that makes any sense. But anyway, want to just quickly jump into this. I am firstly wanted to show you the Nettle pants. I hauled these in my last video, but they were a little short on me, as if you remember, if you saw that video, and they didn't have any pockets. So after the video came out, they said they would be happy to send me a updated pair of pants. So I sent the other ones back, and I'm so excited because they're perfect. They are a little bit short still on me, but they're like the perfect short, if that makes any sense. I feel like it'll like show off your shoe really well. I am 5'8", 5'9"-ish. I have like a 34 inseam just for reference. I'm quite tall. So I love these so much. I think that I always had issues with pant lengths, so I wasn't super surprised when they were a little short on me, to be honest. But these are perfect. I think they're going to be great for like fall transition. I don't know if I would wear this in the full-on winter unless I was wearing it with like a boot, just because there is still some ankle exposed, but they will be great for summer, spring as well. Obviously wearing the matching top right now, which I am obsessed with. I will say too though, linen is kind of like, it's nice because it keeps you warm in the winter, but then it keeps you cool in the summer for some reason. I don't know how. It's just, linen is a magic fabric. So I'll probably try to work these into my rotation during the winter as well. Just will take a little bit more styling and fall-ish layers, if that makes any sense. But excited about these. I just love the color so much. Hey, the next piece is this gorgeous leather jacket. I've been on the hunt for a replacement for a leather jacket I recently had but actually sold because I no longer support that brand. And I'm just obsessed with this. I think it's so good. She has so many different type of leather jackets. This one is the crop version. This exact same leather comes in a longer version, which I actually will be receiving soon. I shot some content, a campaign for her, and I negotiated another leather jacket. And yeah, I'm obsessed with this jacket. I feel like they're super high quality. They're made really, really well. And I love that they have multiple like styles. I think they have like a thicker leather, which is really nice. They have one with like more of a draped collar. I'll intersplice some photos so you can kind of see what I ended up doing. I shot and styled it, and I had Veronica, who's been on this channel before, was the model, and I'm just obsessed with it. I will say, I got this in a 4X. I have kind of bigger arms for whatever reason, so I feel like I tend to size up in jackets specifically for my arms to give me a little bit more room. I feel like the 3X would have fit, and if I had not meant to wear anything thicker under, a 3X would have been fine, but I feel like for me, I personally like a little bit more arm room so I can wear sweaters or something like that. It's still a little snug, but leather will give over time as well, so I didn't want it to be like oversized, if that makes any sense. But yeah, really excited to have this. I've worn it a few times now that fall is officially here and we're moving immediately into winter, but I love that she also is size inclusive. I think she makes her jackets up to 24, so it's not extremely size inclusive, but she is working on expanding. And she is carried at 11 on array as well. Veda is, I don't know if I mentioned it, but the owner's name is Lindsay. So really, really love this brand. Highly recommend you check them out. They are expensive leather jackets, but it is a nice quality leather jacket, so you do get what you pay for. I feel like price point wise, if you're thinking about a nice high quality leather jacket and you're not quite sure where to go, if you are plus, I would say that this is a step below the Henning, in my personal opinion. I think the Henning leather was like amazing. It's a very thick, warm leather. And Veda does have a style that's on the thicker side as well, but in terms of the leather quality, I would kind of rank them that way if you are considering between the two. But The hemming one's also like $500 more, so you get what you pay for.
Hey, moving on, we have this really cute sleep shirt by The Sleep Shirt. This is a Canadian-based brand, I believe, and I actually did a sponsored post for them recently over on my IG. I styled this in a really cute, like, street style vibe. I have like a very similar colored, it's almost like a gray-green, like trench jacket that I got thrifting, which is like honestly one of my favorite finds ever. It was $20 and it's from Barney's, so was a score when I found that. But I just love this. I cannot wait to wear it like all throughout winter because it is flannel, so it's quite warm. I believe this is the only size they have in this, but they are working on expanding. And it has pleats here too, which is nice. It's a little on the short side for me in terms of like if I wanted to wear it as a dress like outside of the home, but inside you'll be seeing me rocking this a lot for sure. Well, you won't be seeing me, but I'll be seeing myself, if that makes any sense. But super, super soft. I did do a sponsored post with them, but mostly just because I found my friend Lydia over, not me, there's another Lydia, over on Instagram. Their Instagram handle is Style is Style. They have worked with the Sleep Shirt before, and that was why I was intrigued by them. So I was excited to do another sponsored sustainable post because I do recognize that sustainable brands have definitely a lot less of a budget for marketing and influencer marketing, which I totally understand. But it is exciting to work with them and really be able to support them in a way that feels a little bit more genuine, if that makes any sense. Moving on, I'm going to show you a couple pieces by Celetica, I believe is the name of the brand. If I'm pronouncing that wrong, I'm really sorry. They sent me three pieces I'm going to show you. This is a white button-down, so pretty, you know, it's definitely just like a go-to basic that you need in your wardrobe, in my opinion. I've been looking everywhere for a good one because I have very broad hips. I'm like, I think my hip ratio right now is like a 42 to like a 53, which it used to be a lot smaller, but you know, my stomach tends to gain weight when, you know, COVID happens. But anyway, it's always hard to find anything that'll fit over my hips. So when I found this, I was super excited when I got it in the mail. Everything fits perfectly from this brand, and it is linen, everything's linen, and I just love it. I mean, it's a good, nice basic. I love the fabric. I think it's super comfortable and just like has a good fall to it. And personally, again, as I was mentioning before, I do think linen is great during the winter because it does keep you warm, and then in the summer it magically somehow keeps you cool, so it does have a lot of versatility there, which I think is great. And I love her like branding. I don't know if you guys can see. No, it's focusing on my face. Little Celetica there. Yeah, it's a good length too. I feel like it's good for tucking in if you wanted to wear it that way, or if you want to wear it open and just like over a bralette, which is kind of probably how I'll style it during the summer months, and fall and spring possibly. But anyway, excited about this because I had one and I wasn't the biggest fan of the way it fell on my wrists, and I think this one is like a perfect fit. So next are these pants. This is a size 6. She has her own sizing set up there, so definitely just check out the size chart. I think they're pretty dead on. I feel like these fit pretty perfectly how I wanted them slightly oversized, and they definitely fit that way. I think they're great. I will say though that I shot these maybe like 2 weeks ago, and I put them on and I was waiting for the photographer, and I sat down and then I stood up and they were wrinkled a ton. So I will make a note that linen wrinkles. It's just the natural fabric. They wrinkle a lot, and it also probably depends on the consistency and thickness. This is a thicker linen that I'm currently wearing. Well, this is a thinner linen, so it does tend to scrunch a lot more. So it just depends. Like, I personally don't care if it wrinkles, but I think for photos, like, I spent some time like making sure everything was, what's that word? Steamed correctly before I, you know, shoot it. I'm just in that photo shoot mode. So that's just something to make note of. I think that you need to be prepared for a linen to wrinkle. Doesn't personally bother me. It's just a photography thing. I've just been taught over the years, you want to make sure everything is like as wrinkle free as possible. But for actual daily wear, I don't really care. I also am obsessed with this color. This is definitely like my winter color choice. Like, it's kind of matches my bedding behind me, if you can tell. I just love this. I think it'll be great with like a camel coat or, you know, a pair of denim, or not a pair of denim, a camel coat, a leather jacket. I just recently got, actually, it probably wouldn't be kind of like this color combo. I just recently rented a like bright neon green sweater from Tanya Taylor from Rent the Runway. I think that would be really cute with this. And I know that it's not maybe what you would traditionally think would be cute with like this color, but I think kind of pairing it with something poppier is kind of fun. But yeah, I really like it. It has pockets too, which we always love. And they're a good length for me. I feel like, as I mentioned, I have issues with that, so was pleasantly surprised. Okay, last piece from Sotelica. I'm really bad with names. I'm so sorry if I'm mispronouncing. Definitely probably am. This is a button-down linen t-shirt dress, and you probably won't be able to tell too much on camera, but it is beautiful. I think it fits perfectly. I've had such a hard time finding a shirt like this that fits again across the hips, and I feel like this fits perfectly. I almost could even go up a size and make it like more baggy and loose fitting, but it really depends on your preference. I just love it. I think it's so pretty. I think it's definitely like will be a great one with like a pair of boots and like maybe like a black leather like trench coat. I have one of those. Or you can wear it unbuttoned over like a pair of denim or anything like that. You can definitely style it multiple ways, which I think is lovely. And it's just nice. I like that she also, I was talking to her via DM, and she was saying that like you can pick your buttons on some of the pieces, which I think is cool. Does have a front pocket as well, and doesn't have actual pockets on the side. I will say too, I love the majority of these brands in terms of their plus representation. I'm going to show you one more brand that I do feel like could do a little bit better in terms of their model choices, but I feel like the rest of them has done a really good job with making sure they're accurately representing the customers that are trying to purchase them, which I think is amazing and honestly should just be done at this point. Last but not least, we have SB. This is a brand I found, I think randomly through Mary Elizabeth, just like on one of her lists. And I really wanted to like this brand because I love a lot of their styles. I think they're really, really high quality, very nicely made pieces. And I do like them, I will say. I feel like I'm kind of a little torn because I feel like I love what they're doing. I feel like they have a lot of fun styles. I love that they have a unisex section, but they do need to have better plus representation. I feel like the model choices that they've done are typically like a size 12, 14. And I feel like all the other sustainable brands that I really have been, you know, working with or have become aware of are doing great representation. And I feel like they're kind of coming up lackluster. I feel like I do think it's important. And I think so many of these other sustainable brands have kind of hit the nail. And this one is definitely lacking. I will say I really love these pants though, and I would wear them in multiple colors. I think they sent me a couple other pieces, and one was very similar to a nettle piece I already had. And I was like, well, I don't really want that one because I already have something that I really like. And then they sent me a jumpsuit. It was too big. And I really have been wanting a pair of white linen pants for the longest time. And I did have a pair from, it was a suit set from Vincetta Studio, which is like a tailoring like suit website, but I ended up tie-dyeing it, which I may show that in like a tie-dye video. Actually, I think I might do that today. It was just a little thin, to be honest, and I feel like this is a lot thicker of a material, so it tends to conceal everything. I think that was just the style of the pant. It's not like anything bad about it. I just think in terms of like actual wearability, something thicker like this is going to be more up my alley. And I like the length on them. I love the way the pant leg is. I will say the only complaint is I don't love a button fly. I feel like with someone with a belly, it tends to like expand a little bit more than I'm comfortable with, and it was pulling a touch across the belly. So I feel like with a longer top, I'm comfortable, I'm fine. I wore it with a sleep shirt, as I mentioned previously, for a style look, and I really liked that. I wore it with a pair of white boots too, and I just liked the way they looked with like that flared leg at the bottom. So yeah, I mean, like I said, sort of torn opinion about this brand. I do think that they have some really fun pieces. I just would like to see a little bit more representation. I know that they have not worked with any sustainable bloggers or influencers that have been really working at this industry for years, even before, you know, I feel like I'm very new to this. So it's me just kind of like scrambling to sort of figure out and navigate everything. And I've been super thankful, I will say, to Marielle, Lydia. There's been so many other people. My friend Nicolette has really been sort of diving into it. She did it before me, more so, but like I'm really trying to dive in as well. So we're sort of just piggybacking off of each other and trying to, you know, give each other feedback and suggestions and just like, I don't know. I really love this community and I'm really thankful that I found it. But yeah, that's it. I hope you guys are enjoying your day. If you want to see anything specific from me, definitely comment below and I will try to make that happen. And yeah, I'll see you in my next video. Bye!